For more Bollywood gossip, hit the bell icon and never miss a video. Recently, the Sultan had returned to Mumbai, taking a break from his shooting schedule in Abu Dhabi. Yes, we are talking about Salman Khan, who came to Mumbai to spend a day with his family during Ganesh Chaturthi. This time, the venue of the celebrations had shifted from Salman's Galaxy Apartments to sister Arpita Khan Sharma's new home. Salman was the first guest to arrive, and what is this we see? He is sporting a new bracelet, a brand new one. Well, looking at the way Bhai is known to wear his accessories, we wonder if this is his new lucky charm or just another addition to his ever-growing kitty of accessories. Any guesses? Do let us know. We did tell you that Salman is busy with his upcoming Tiger Zinda Hai, starring him and Katrina Kaif. We also do know that it is a sequel to the original Ek Tha Tiger, directed by Kabir Khan, where the protagonists are raw agents. Well, this tweet only shows that the tiger is ready to strike. Well, we are too eager to watch the flick after this tweet. It only means that the Tiger team has taken out its armory, and aren't we excited about it? And this picture, which shows that 10,000 rounds of firings are happening, so obviously the Tiger is ready to strike. As for Salman, he was seen celebrating Ganpati with Sanjay Dutt, and now that all the Bhai Chara is over, we guess Salman is up with a new avatar. After all, he has promised the best for his fans. So what do you have to say about this?
Thank you.
Dabang Khan is back in India, but wait a minute, where is his Tigress? Well, Cat is still at Abu Dhabi, shooting for Tiger Zinda Hai, while Cat continues to sweat it out in UAE. Well, it seems that Salman will finally be a part of Ganesh Chaturthi celebration, and we will surely be delighted to see some amazing pictures of the Bhaijaan with our Bappa. But for now, here we have some amazing pictures of Salman Khan at the airport. His unmistakable swag and style is what makes him so mesmerizing. The enigmatic smile makes us wonder what secrets he is hiding. Well, with Bigg Boss 11 coming up soon, we surely must expect something out of the box. So while we wait for Bhai's next move, do let us know your comments about these airport pictures. Didn't we tell you that Salman Khan would be doing race 3 and would keep Remo's godaddy on hold? Well, it is again a Remo-Salman combo with Jacqueline in tow in the upcoming race sequel. And here is Jackie herself confirming it. Yes, aren't we excited to again see the kick pair back together? Jacqueline is also busy with her upcoming A Gentleman. However, she has said yes to race 3, and this is a great news for us as we would love to see her with Bhaijaan again. However, it is not the Bhai duo Abbas Mastan who would be directing the trequel. Instead, it would be Remo D'Souza who would do it, and we sure would love to see this new angle to the race series. Jacqueline was a part of race 2, but with Salman replacing Saif, we wonder what the turnaround would be. Do let us know what do you think about this. Sometime back, it was Malaika who was the best item girl. However, reports have it that Sunny Leon has taken over Malaika in Bhumi's Trippy Trippy song. Yes, this is the item number that is doing the rounds to no end, and we are quite kicked to see Sunny belting out hits after hits without a break. First it was Lela Melela from Raiz, and now there was the Pia Mori from Badshaho, and now we have this Trippy song from Bhumi. Well, Malaika obviously has reasons for not taking the now popular song, for it is apparently because of dates that Malaika could not take it. Well, we sure would miss Malaika, but her loss is Sunny's gain, and we sure are loving that too. What do you say? Do you wish to see more of Malaika or Sunny? Do let us know. Sanjay Leela Bhansali's magnum opus Padmavati is slated to release in November, and fans are delighted to see the real-life lovers Deepika Padukone and Ranveer Singh play the roles of Padmavati and antagonist Alauddin Khilji. But recently we got to know that these two talented stars were not the first choice of the filmmaker, who had initially approached Salman and Aishwarya for the role. But following their bitter breakup years ago, this project didn't see the light of the day, and years later, while reviving it, Sanjay once more approached the two. The grapevine is abuzz with the news that Ash was more than desperate to share screen space with Salman Khan. But sadly, the Dabang Khan was offered the role of Alauddin Khilji. Obviously, Salman would not accept it and outright denied. And so Aishwarya's dream of working with her former lover did not come true. So what do you feel about Aishwarya's desperation to work with Salman? Do let us know by commenting in the section. Well, Salman sure ensures his girls don't go unnoticed in his flicks, and here he has not only Sonakshi but also Ulya in his upcoming trequel to the popular Dabang series. Yes, the Dabang Pandey would be romancing Sonakshi, the original Dabang girl, along with Salman's rumored real-life girl, Ulya. Yes, the role for Ulya is not yet decided, but she may be a part of the team. As for Ulya, well, we did see how she went and made herself noticeable when Salman and Kat were shooting for Tiger Zinda Hai. It was also felt she may have gone on a checking spree. However, word has it that Salman has not yet said anything about his relation with Ulya. Yet the fact that she is in his upcoming flick only puts her on the lines of Jacqueline, Daisy Shah, Sunny Leon, etc., who owe their career to Salman. What do you feel about Ulya making a Bollywood break? Do let us know by commenting in the section below. and you are the diva, you are in focus, and this is what happened with Aishwarya Rai recently when she was caught looking cheesy in a wardrobe malfunction. Ash was with her daughter Aradhya and was apparently explaining something to her. Obviously, if you are wearing a lovely low-cut gown, you are bound to show off your better assets to the world. The paparazzi is waiting for a slip-up moment and then to catch it on cam, and Ash more than had a malfunction. It was a long moment of slip-up and we are here sharing it with you, asking if you feel Ash should have been more careful, or is it that we give her the benefit of aging? Of course not, the evergreen diva is still as fresh as a nimbura in people's brains, and it is hard to imagine someone of her caliber to have let this go unnoticed. Hena. Salman Khan was seen in Abu Dhabi with Indian actor Nawab Shah. Yes, we do know that the Dabang Bhaijaan is getting ready with his sequel to Ek Tha Tiger in the form of the upcoming Tiger Zinda Hai. We also did tell you that some high-octane scenes were shot across the world in Morocco, Dubai, Abu Dhabi, etc. And now we find Bhaijaan in his wrap-up mood with Nawab Shah. Salman had promised his fans that he would give a fair treatment to their love and told he would give them a good entertainer unlike the damn tube light. So with Tiger Zinda Hai and sequels to Dabang and Race in the Kitty, we guess Sallu is all the way weaving his way into the hearts of his followers. What say? Sanjay Leela Bhansali's magnum opus Padmavati is slated to release in November, and fans are delighted to see the real-life lovers Deepika Padukone and Ranveer Singh play the roles of Padmavati and antagonist Alauddin Khilji. But recently, we got to know that these two talented stars were not the first choice of the filmmaker, who had initially approached Salman and Aishwarya for the role. But following their bitter breakup years ago, this project didn't see the light of the day, and years later, while reviving it, Sanjay once more approached the two. While Ash did give her consent on the condition that she shares no scenes with Salman Khan, the Dabang Bhaijaan would not settle for any role which didn't give him the chance to recreate his Hum Dil De Chuke Sanam chemistry with Ash. So Salman turned down the project outright, and Sanjay had to begin hunting for other stars to pitch in. While we would love to see Shahid, Deepika and Ranveer Singh's magic in the film, this news does sound quite disappointing for all Sallu Ash fans. Hena. The bonding between Bhai and Munna Bhai was considered as one of the most loving ones in Bollywood, but speculations that their friendship is over makes for gossip in industry circles. It all reportedly began from the time when Salman Khan asked Sanjay Dutt to play the role of his father in Bodyguard in 2011. It seems that Sanjay felt bad as he was not that old to play Salman's father and refused the offer, which did not go well with the superstar. Sanjay Dutt, during the interviews for Bhumi, was asked whom does he feel protective about. Sanju Baba took a few names and Bhai's name was also there in the list. He said, "I know I cannot protect them, but I feel like an elder brother." Now this is a perfect answer for everyone who felt that it was over between them. We sure are happy to hear this news. What about you? Do let us know by commenting in the section.